Now, do you like stories? Because here's an amazing story. A Kiwi woman writes a thriller. She sends it away. Now, plenty of aspiring writers have done just that, and it ends up in a publishing slush pile. That's the stuff submitted that no one wants to read.
This story, though, ends differently. Her book gets a big publishing deal in the US, then the UK, then Hollywood options it. Tim Wilson turns the pages on Rose Carlyle's amazing tale.
Movie thriller big time. Jack Reacher.
You think you're above the law, but I'm not the law.
The girl on the train.
I'm not the girl I used to be.
Now Hollywood, which needs content, may have found the next blockbuster right here in New Zealand.
I mean, crazy, right? I had no idea that you could sell a book to Hollywood before it was even published.
A big, fat pre-publication option for the girl in the mirror and its author, Rose Carlyle.
It all just happened so fast, and I still can't give you any specifics, but yeah, it's been amazing.
Tom Cruise.
Why does everyone ask me about Tom Cruise?
Ask Rose about her dreams. When she was six, wanting to be a writer, she was given a typewriter. The same typewriter that she rests her laptop on today, the one she used for The Girl in the Mirror, her first book.
It was probably the worst time in my life to write a novel because I was actually starting a new job for the first time in a long time. I'd been a stay-at-home mum and I had four teenagers, and so I started just getting up really early in the morning to write. And I think the reason I did that was I just needed an escape.
A novel of escape, overflowing with Hollywood-sized greed, secrets and deadly lies.
I just sent it off to one publisher and it sat on the slush pile for a couple of months with no one looking at it.
When I read it, I thought, my goodness, this is quite incredible. On the first page, well-constructed, quite gripping, so I kept reading.
Alan and Unwin's publishing director, Jenny Helen, isn't usually a big fan of the slush pile.
Normally with the slush pile, you probably don't read very much of it, of one novel, but I kept reading.
Reading herself into promoting the novel overseas, which led to big offers from publishers in the UK and the US.
It's just an email, and you read it and you can't believe your eyes, because I didn't know anything about American publishing. I didn't realise that they made these big offers, and it was life-changing.
Once Rose's lawyer day job meant signing a lot of legal documents. Today, it's copies of her novel at Paper Plus.
Holding this in your local bookstore, what does it feel like?
It feels incredible. It's not quite real. I can't quite, because you imagine something so many times that when it really happens, it feels like just another dream.
Leaving Rose Carlyle, who wrote in the darkness of early morning, basking in the bright light of success.
What's happening to Rose is quite phenomenal.
My dream come true was to write a book and get it published. So my dream came true at that point. This is now like a dream on top of a dream. I just don't know how to describe it.
And if you go to our Facebook page, we've got a couple of copies of Rose's book to give away. Answer the question and you are in to win.